Hello everyone again, welcome back to our online class. This is Tuesday, right? So Tuesday we always learn about Blueprint 2, right? So on Monday and Tuesday we always learn about Blueprint 2. What did we learn yesterday? So yesterday we learned about Blueprint 2, right? But what you need? You need one, a new place. How about lesson? Lesson 5, right? So yesterday we learned about lesson 5, I feel happy. And lesson 5, like I told you yesterday, it is the last lesson of the unit, right? So unit 5, lesson 5. And today we are going, so yesterday I promised with you that we are going to do all the exercise on workbook of lesson 5 and lesson 4, right? Lesson 4 and lesson 5, okay? I promise you that. And today we are going to do all the exercise in lesson 4 and lesson 5. Not we, you. You have to do all the exercise in lesson 4 and lesson 5, okay? But before we go to our exercises, let's review what we learned yesterday. So yesterday we learned about lesson 5. Here, I feel happy, right? And there are a lot of vocabularies, especially about the words that describe about the feeling, right? So as you can see here, are some of the adjective, some of the word of feelings that I taught you yesterday, right? So let's go to the first one altogether. Can you read this word? Yep, fortunate. So what does mean fortunate? So fortunate means very lucky, right? Very lucky, okay? Example, you forget to review the lesson before the quiz one, but then you get 30, you didn't fail, right? Because if the full score of quiz 1 of ABI school is 50, right? And it means if you get 25, it means you pass. But you get 30, it means you pass too. So you didn't review the lesson, but you pass. It means that I am so fortunate to pass the exam. It means I am very lucky to pass the exam. I just write and then I pass, okay? It means you are fortunate, very lucky. But don't try to do it, okay? Try to review the lesson. This one, can you read? Yeah, guilty is a feeling of guilt. You feel bad when you do something wrong to someone, okay? Example, when you have a fight, when you have an argument with your friends and then you fight each other, hit each other, and after you everything is done, after both of you calm down, and then you feel guilty. I should not hit her, or I should not hit him, okay? You feel guilty. So when you are angry, don't try to use violence, don't try to fight, don't try to hit, just find a solution, okay? Just find a peaceful way to solve the problem. It's one, calm. So if you are a calm person, it means that you don't speak a lot and you don't really worry about anything, okay? This one, panic. So panic, we refer to a sudden feeling of fear, right? So like I gave you the example yesterday, when you are in your house and then a thief come to your house and then you feel panic, okay? And this one, joyful means very happy, right? Delighted means joyful, very happy. So if you try to study hard, if you get the number one, your parents will be delighted with you, okay? It means they are very happy with you. Scared. When you are scared of something, it means you are afraid of something or you are frightened of something. This one, embarrassed. Embarrassed and ashamed are the same. They are similar. Ashamed or embarrassed, it means that you feel shy or you feel embarrassed of doing something. Example, you are sitting in a class and then there is a new student, and that student is a beautiful girl and you are a handsome boy, example, and then you always look when she comes to her seat, but you always look at her all the time because she is beautiful, okay? And then she just looks at you and then you try to act that you are not looking at her. So you feel embarrassed when she knows that you always look at her. So you feel embarrassed, you feel shy. This one, passionate, passionate, passionate. So passionate, if you are a passionate person, it means you have a strong feeling towards something. If you are a passionate singer, it means that you are a wonderful singer. You sing very beautifully, okay? If you are a passionate student, it means that you are very hardworking at studying. You love studying. You do your exercise. You do your homework every day. Disappointed. 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 So disappointed, when it means you feel sad or feel unhappy about things that you want, but it did not happen. Frustrated. Frustrated when you feel bad or you feel angry at something that you want, but it didn't happen. And then nervous. Nervous. Nervous refer to the feeling of worried or the feeling of anxious. Okay, example, if you are scared of height, H-E-I-G-H-T, if you are scared of height, it means that when you go to the building that is 10 floors or 20 floors, you will feel nervous because you are afraid of height. Okay, so these are some of the words or feelings that we learned yesterday. So now let's go to what we learned today. But today, like I promised you yesterday, we are going to do all the exercise in lesson 4 of your workbook, right? So now please open your workbook on page 39. So page 39 here is lesson 4, is the exercise that I promised you that you have to do yesterday. So lesson 4, there are 4 exercises, right? I'm sorry, there are 3 exercises. So number 1, put a check mark next to the correct answer. So easy, right? So just read these 6 sentences and there are 2 answers in each sentence, but you have to check the correct one. I'm sorry, there are 3 answers to each sentence. Example number 1, King Avenue has blah 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 traffic in the city, has bad traffic in the city, has the worst traffic in the city, or has the worst traffic in the city. So you have to correct the answer. Check on the correct answer. There is only one correct answer in each sentence. Okay, so number 1, you do it by yourself. And number 2, listen to the conversation and mark whether the tone goes up or down at the end of each sentence. Then answer the questions below. You know, tone means the sound. Example, tone goes up or down. If tone goes up, hello. Hello, so the tone goes up. Hello, if I say sorry, so the tone goes down, right? Sorry, so it goes down. Hello, sorry, hello, sorry. Okay, so now I will play the listening for you and try to listen at the end of each sentence. Example, Lisa, how do you like your new apartment building? Building, so when we ask question, the tone always goes up, right? Lisa, how do you like your apartment building? Building, and the answer, I really love it. It's so close. It's so close. The tone goes down. It's not, it's so close. So the tone goes up. Here, but here, it's so close. So the tone goes down. So try to listen to each sentence, especially at the end of the sentence. So now, let's listen.
Track 23. Lisa, how do you like your new apartment building?
I really love it. It's so close.
How do you get from there to school?
Well, walking down John Street is the prettiest way.
Is that the fastest way, too?
When I drive, it's fast. It only takes 5 minutes.
Yeah, really close then. Is it expensive?
No, it's the cheapest building in the neighborhood.
It sounds like a nice place to live.
There's a 1-bedroom apartment available. It's only $600 a month. Check it out.
Are pets allowed?
Oh, they're not. Sorry.
Okay, so now I'm sure that you have listened to the listening number 2 already, right? And don't forget to answer these 2 questions, number 13 and number 14, okay? And then let's go to exercise 3. Exercise 3, complete the crossword. So here there are like, I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there are 6 words that you need to complete, right? So you have to do it by yourself too. Cross means it's like this. Down, it means from up to down, okay? So number 1, number 2, number 3, down. Number 4, 5, 6, cross. So you have to, you can read the sentences, read the clue here, and you will find the words. All of those words are the words that you have learned already. So now, let's go to lesson 5. So lesson 5 here, as you can see on the whiteboard, it is on page 40. So here, on workbook page 40, unit 5, a new place, lesson 5, I feel happy. So there are two exercises that I am going to correct for you today. The first one, fill in the blanks with the words from the box. So there are such the word sad, nervous, surprised, happy, angry, and stressed. So now let's go to sentence number one. Mr. and Mrs. Wellington look really blah 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 to see the doctor. She never tell. I'm sorry, I forget the letter S here. She never tells them when she's coming home. Read again. Mr. and Mrs. Wellington look really blah 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 to see the doctor. She never tells them when she's coming home. So Mr. and Mrs. Wellington look really bored. So the doctor is coming home, but she never tells them. It means the doctor never tells her parents. So how do they feel when they see the doctor coming home without the doctor telling them? So they look very sad, nervous, surprised, happy, angry, or stressed. So when you say something that you don't expect, you have to use surprised, right? So Mr. and Mrs. Wellington look really surprised to see the doctor. Why? Because she's coming home, but she never tells them that she's coming home. So that's why when you see the doctor, oh, surprised. Now let's go to number two. Oh, forget, we have to underline here so that we know that we used that word already. So let's go to number two. My brother has too much work and now he's becoming more and more. So my brother has too much work. So when you have too much work, when you have a lot of work, you feel what? You feel happy, you feel sad, you feel nervous, you feel angry, or you feel stressed? Of course, stressed, right? Because when you have a lot of work, you will feel stressed. Oh, I'm so stressed. Okay, so stressed already. Let's go to number three. They appear when their grandfather died. So when someone, when the family member in, I mean, when a member in our family die, we always feel sad, right? So sad is the answer to number three. Let's go to number four. Nobuto, maybe this is the name. Nobuto seems really blah 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 about his son's low math grade. Nobuto seems worried blah 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 about his son's low math grade. So I want you to focus on this word low. Math grade, this phrase. So if you are a dad and you have a son and your son has very low score in math grade or in any subject, how do you feel? Do you feel nervous? Do you feel happy? Or do you feel angry? Of course you feel angry, right? So the answer, he is angry. Nobuto seems very angry about his son's low math grade because he wants his son to be good at math. Let's go to number five. I'm always afraid blah 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 on planes because I'm afraid to fly. So when you are afraid of something, it means you are nervous, right? Okay, so now we have only one. I'm sure you know the answer already, right? So she always gets really happy just before the weekend. So on the weekend, we always have a chance to go to somewhere, right? To go to the place that we want to go. So that's why before the weekend, she gets very happy. It means she is very happy. So now we have finished our exercise number one, but before we go to number two, let's read again. Number one, Mr. and Mrs. Wellington. So here, letter T, right? So we have to read ten, not ton, okay, or ton, okay? Mr. and Mrs. Wellington look really surprised to see the doctor. She never tells them when she's coming home. Number two, my brother has too much work and now he's becoming more and more stressed. Number three, they appear sad when their grandfather died. Number four, Nobuto seems very angry about his son's low math grade. Number five, I'm always feel nervous on planes because I'm afraid to fly. Number six, she always gets very happy just before the weekend. Okay, so now we have finished exercise number one. Let's go to exercise number two. Here, put the words in order to make sentences. So here there are five sentences, but it is not in order. So we have to put it in order in order to make the correct sentences. So let's go to number one. Tired, always work after I feel. Very stressed, very stressful, right? So what is your answer? I feel tired. I always feel tired after work, right? So number one, I always feel tired after work. Let's go to number two. We have cafe man looks that the upset in. So how can you create one correct sentence using these words? The man in cafe looks upset, right? Okay, so number two, the man in cafe looks upset. Let's go to number three. We have night, the afraid, she seems bus to take an eight. So how you create one correct sentence using these words? Can you try to do it? What is your answer? So she seems afraid to take the bus at night, right? So the answer to number three, she seems afraid to take the bus at night. For me, before I was afraid to take the bus at night too, but now I am not afraid anymore. So my hometown is in Bandung province. So when I want to go there, I always leave from here at 7 p.m. at night. And I take the bus at night, and at 6 o'clock in the morning, I arrive at my hometown. Okay, so I sleep one night on the bus. Some people, they are worried, they are nervous about being on the bus at night, but because I have no choice, because I don't have a lot of time, so I have to go at night, and I arrive there in the morning, and then when I finish my work there, I leave there at night and arrive here in the morning, and then I come to work. Let's go to number four. Before Nancy worry holiday happy gets up. So what is your answer? How can you create one sentence? So Nancy gets worry happy before a holiday. Okay, so the answer is Nancy gets very happy before a holiday. Let's go to the last one. Sounds about chairman. This is probably the name. I think it is the name. Her worried exam. So what is your answer? So chairman here is the name of a girl. So chairman sounds worried about her exam. Okay, so the answer to number five is chairman sounds worried about her exam. Okay, so now we have finished our exercise number two, but let's read again. Number one, can you read? Yeah, I always feel tired after work. Number two, yeah, the man in cafe looks upset. Number three, yeah, she seems afraid to take the bus at night. Number four, yeah, Nancy gets very happy before a holiday. And the last one, can you understand my letters? Chairman sounds worried about her exam. Okay, so now we have finished lesson five of our workbook, exercise number one and exercise number two. But we have one more exercise, right? Exercise number three, as you can see here on page 40. Exercise number three is very easy. Write sentences to describe the picture, the photos, I'm sorry. So there are three photos, number one, number two, and number three. This little girl looks what? Looks happy, looks sad, or look what? So you have to do number one, number two, and number three, okay? That is your classwork. Now, let's go to your homework. Your homework is on your Blueprint 2 student book on page 74. Here, on page 74 here, this is your homework. On page 74, exercise A, calling a landlord. So listen to Christopher, ask questions about apartment, fill in the blanks with the missing information. So here there are two conversations, conversation one, conversation two, but you cannot do if you don't listen. So I will play the listening for you, but before I play the listening for you, I just want to say that today is Tuesday, right? So tomorrow is Wednesday. We are going to study about writing bright, right? So don't forget your homework. So now I will play the listening for you, and goodbye.
Track 40.
1.
Hello, I'm calling about the apartment in today's paper. Is it still available?
Yes, it is. The rent is $500 a month.
Where's it located?
1544 South Road. The apartment is number 17.
Could I come by tomorrow at 3 o'clock to have a look?
Yes. Call me when you get near. The number is 555-0202. 2.
Hello, I'm calling about the apartment for rent. Is it still available?
Yes, it is. It's $1,200 a month.
What's the address?
It's 1544 East Avenue, apartment 17.
Can I come to see it tomorrow at 3 p.m.?
Yes. Text me when you get here. The number is 555-0202.
Track 40.
1.
Hello, I'm calling about the apartment in today's paper. Is it still available?
Yes, it is. The rent is $500 a month.
Where's it located?
1544 South Road. The apartment is number 17.
Could I come by tomorrow at 3 o'clock to have a look?
Yes. Call me when you get near. The number is 555-0202. 2.
Hello, I'm calling about the apartment for rent. Is it still available?
Yes, it is. It's $1,200 a month.
What's the address?
It's 1544 East Avenue, apartment 17.
Can I come to see it tomorrow at 3 p.m.?
Yes. Text me when you get here. The number is 555-0202.